Hey guys, my name is Dylan Kessner. I'm a part of the NRMT 499 course, and I did my research on writing narratives for signage at Stonewall Jackson Resort. Some of the project background, grants were given to Stonewall Jackson to invest in signs for the Lakeside Nature Trail. My task was to come up with topics to write narratives on, which would be used for the signs. It's hard to really see exactly the trail here, but this is a picture of Stonewall Jackson Resort, and this is actually the lodge right here. The trail starts right here by the lodge, works its way around, goes around the lake, comes out over here, and comes back up the road here to the lodge. Hence the name Lakeside Nature Trail. So a little bit about the Lakeside Nature Trail. Like I said, the trail starts at the lodge, works its way around the Carrion Bay, back to the lodge again. The total distance of the trail is 3.2 miles, and the trail offers easy walking and biking surfaces. This trail has great view of the lake, wooded areas, as well as old U.S. Route 19. Why signs? Trail signage provides tourists a great resource for those walking on the trail. It also gives direction, information, also informs tourists of risk and hazards while on the trails. My objective for this project was to produce narratives which can be used for the signage on the Lakeside Nature Trail. Methods. So my methods included finding the topics for the narratives, researching on those topics. That involved also meeting with professionals for more information. On some of the topics anyway, writing narratives for each topic, editing the narratives, and then presenting the finished narratives at Stonewall Jackson Resort. So here's some of the topics, or all the topics that I chose. I chose birds, butterflies, conservation and safety, dam information, native vegetation, non-native vegetation, wetlands, and wildlife. And I'll talk a little bit about each one of these. So, the birds topic that I chose, I decided to break these down into three subtopics, or species here. Birds of prey, common waterfowl, and woodpeckers and songbirds. For the birds of prey, the species that I chose were bald eagle, turkey vulture, and Cooper's hawk. For common waterfowl, I chose mallard and Canadian geese. For the woodpeckers and songbirds, I chose the pileated woodpecker, downy woodpecker, American robin, and the tufted titmouse. Some of the descriptions that I used in these narratives were Latin names. I used identification features of the birds to help identify them out in the field, and also some interesting facts that I thought would be pretty cool for people to read. The next narrative that I wrote on was butterflies. I spent pretty much this whole narrative just talking about the monarch butterfly, since it was a main species, keystone species, throughout the United States. And the resort has a lot of milkweed, which will bring in the monarchs, so I decided just to write it on the monarch butterfly. And in this narrative, I describe the migratory patterns, life cycle, identification, and as well as other interesting facts. My conservation and safety sign, I spent the first little part of the narrative talking about ticks and also poisonous plant species, which are common to West Virginia. Also good conduct while on the trail, so no horseplay, no littering, such things like that. Trail conditions and hazards that people could find, so uplifted rocks, roots, things like that, which would be hazardous while walking or biking the trail. The next sign, topic that I came up with was dam information. This goes along with Stonewall Jackson Dam. I talked to a dam technician who was working for the Army Corps of Engineers for Stonewall Jackson Dam. I decided to use most of the information that he gave me, since he gave me a lot of information, great information. So I use that in my narratives. And the narratives pretty much covered a wide variety of topics regarding the dam's project, start completion dates, the history of the dam and also environmental impacts to the surrounding area. Next topic was native vegetation. For this narrative, I had a botanist from here at Glenville State College assist me with helping to identify plant species out on the trail. I chose three subtopics to write about: trees, shrubs, and herbaceous plants. For each of these species, I presented a quick description, identification of the species, and also cool facts provided in the narrative. Same thing for the non-native vegetation as well. The same botanist came with me, and we looked at non-native and invasive species on the trail. And just like the previous slide, I did three subtopics: the trees, shrubs, and herbaceous plants. This narrative features the plants, or the features of the plants, and why they're non-native or invasive species, and what kind of environmental impacts they have to the environment. Second to last topic here I chose is wetlands. This is a really important topic to the environment. So at the start of the Lakeside Nature Trail, there's actually a small wetland, and this is classified as a non-tidal marsh. These are pretty common wetlands around rivers, ponds, streams, etc. So in my narrative, I pretty much pointed out the importance of wetlands in regards to the environment, some of the diversity that could be found there, both plants and animal species. And also today, some of the destruction that's happening that's across the United States due to urbanization that's destroying these really needed habitats for certain species. So my last topic here is wildlife. In my wildlife narrative, I pretty much talked about several different species of land mammals, such as deer, squirrels, rabbits, reptiles like the box turtle, aquatic species, snapping turtles, and also a non-native species. One was a wild boar that's intruding into West Virginia and across the United States. These narratives describe each species, a little bit about their characteristics and some interesting facts about each, and also some environmental impacts that they have on the environment. The species were selected for the narratives that would represent the state and the area very well. It would be pointless to pick species that weren't really, you know, important to the area or had an impact on the area. So I tried to keep it local and pick species that were commonly seen. So after I chose my topics and did all my research, I went through an editing process, wrote a draft of all the narratives, and submitted it to Rico Gazal and also Samantha Norris, who was heading this project at Stonewall Jackson, for them to edit and to help me with edits and stuff like that. They got me back those edits, and I printed out typed up a final copy of the narratives, and I submitted them to Samantha at the end of the last summer, this past summer anyway. And the signage, from last I've heard, should be up by the spring of 2018, sometime in May, I hear. So hopefully that gets done. I would like to thank Rico Gazal, Samantha Norris, Stonewall Jackson Resort, and also Glenville State College. Here's some of my resources. Thank you.